Last week, the National Unity Platform president, Robert Kyagulanyi, announced that he would traverse the country to open his party offices and mobilize support in different districts. The nationwide tour, which kicked off today in Barara City, attracted huge crowds of NUP supporters. Addressing the media, the police spokesperson, Fred Enanga, warned Kyagulanyi to follow the security guidelines in place.
Leadership has tasked all territorial commanders in the 12 regions of Rwenzori, that is in Barara, Rwenzori West in Fort Poto, Rwenzori East in Kasese, Kigezi, Kabale, our region in Busoga East at Iganga, Bukedi South, that is Tororo, Elgon, based in Mbare, East Choga, based in Soroti, North Choga, based in Lira, Aswa West, that is in Gulu, Savannah here in Luwero, and West Nile in Arua, to liaise with the organizers from the National Unity Platform and ensure a smooth conduct of the planned activities. Although political party activities at respective party offices are lawful activities,
Kyagulanyi and his team have also been advised to strictly stick to indoor activities and avoid any form of open gatherings, processions and rallies, as these are contravening the security standard. At all venues, the NUP leaders are supposed to provide proof of permission for their activities.
All political parties are still obligated to disclose the specific locations of their mobilization campaigns outside their party offices or premises for safety and security reasons. You're aware during the previous mobilization campaigns, we registered incidents ranging from accidents, vandalism, assaults, and even breach of peace. Therefore, we call upon the NUP organizers to avail proof of permission from owners of venues to be used outside the NUP offices.
While announcing their nationwide tour last week, the NUP Secretary General Louise Rubongoya said they had already written to the Inspector General of Police and the Electoral Commission, as well as getting permission from the owners of the premises where they are to hold the mobilization. Territorial police commanders have also been put on notice that in the event that NUP fails to fulfill their obligation, their activities will be blocked.
Guided the territorial commanders to ensure that the activities are restricted to town halls and other appropriately enclosed areas. That means there will be no open rallies, no processions and assemblies that have potential of disrupting the activities of the wider public.
Meanwhile, as children return home for their school holidays, parents have been advised to come up with security measures to protect their children, especially against strangers. Designing a family code is one of the means a family can strengthen the security of its members, as police spokesperson explained.
We call upon families to develop family codes or family code words. It's important to come up with a code word which you, the parents, elders or guardians can use to reassure or warn every member of the family in a potentially dangerous situation. Of course, it can seem like a fun game for the kids, but it has the genuine safety benefits when you develop a family code as a family, whereby if you're in danger, you can press and send that code. It should be one that is easy to remember.
Enanga further urges parents to protect their children against all forms of immorality.
Such holidays like this, that some of our children get unwanted touches, bad pictures, favors from adults, and we have adults who like tickling children during holidays like this and hugging them. So it's important to tell your child how to say no when they are children or elders who do things that are inappropriate.
Rachel Nachuala and Imlat Charity for the news.